This animation addresses three common variations of S-type seismic body waves. All are shearing waves that travel through the mantle in all directions away from the epicenter of an earthquake. We won't address shear waves that change behavior as they pass the core mantle boundary in this animation. S waves travel a simple curved path through the Earth's mantle, refracting along layers at depth, and return to the surface at the angle they left the epicenter. S waves arrive at seismograph station up to about 103 degrees from the epicenter only. The liquid outer core stops the motion of the shear waves. Only compressional waves can travel through the liquid. The shaded area, after 103 degrees, is referred to as a seismic shadow zone. We will learn that it is indeed a shadow, not a complete blackout to variations of the S wave. The first variation of the S wave is the SS wave that travels through the mantle only, but bounces once off the Earth's surface between the epicenter and the recording seismometer. SS waves can be seen at recording stations any distance from the epicenter. Again, it is a simple S wave that is reflected off the surface of the Earth at an angle that it arrived. If it is reflected a third time, it would be called an SSS wave. Another way that the shearing energy can arrive at recording seismometers in the S-wave shadow zone is by diffracting off the mantle core boundary. If the advancing S-wave strikes the mantle core boundary at a critical angle, it will travel along the base of the mantle, sending shearing energy back to the surface to seismometers within the shadow zone. These ray paths are labeled Pdiff. They usually have small amplitudes and gradual onsets on seismograms due to the loss of energy as the waves are diffracted by the core mantle boundary. If we put all of these shearing wave arrivals from a single earthquake together, we get an interwoven pattern that explains why it can be difficult to interpret seismograms from large earthquakes. To learn more about shadow zones and P waves, visit our website.